हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज श्रवण। दिस इज माय यूट्यूब चैनल सिविल इंजीनियरिंग बाय श्रवण। टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल क्लिक ऑन सब्सक्राइब बटन एंड क्लिक ऑन बेल आइकन फॉर मोर इंटरेस्टिंग अपडेट्स। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू डिजाइन ऑफ G+2 बिल्डिंग इन हाई सिस्मिक जोन बाय यूजिंग स्टार्ट प्रो VIT सॉफ्टवेयर। जनरली एज पर इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड सिस्टम द जोन्स वाज डिवाइडेड इनटू 4 टाइप्स, so which is consisting of zone 2 condition, zone 3 condition, zone 4 condition, zone 5 condition. In this tutorial I will cover the concept which is related to designing part of G+2 in zone 5 condition, nothing but your high seismic zone. So initially I will show you the floor plan for the respected G+2 house. So go to select this respected option. So this is my floor plan for the respected house of G+2. So this is the parking area. So this is the hall, this is the bedroom, this is the children bedroom, this is the opening area and dining section, kitchen section. So this is the utility section. This plan was in south facing direction. The dimensions of this respected south facing will be of 30 feet and this respected length will be of 70 feet for this respected house. It will be consisting of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Total number of columns will be consisting of 12 numbers for this respected house. So in this case, just I am assuming center to center distance between this respected first column to second column is 5 meter. Again, I am taking second column to third meter is 5 meter and third column to fourth column is 3 meter. In the vertical direction, just I am assuming this respected distance of 3 meter and this respected distance of 4 meter. So initially I will create the ground story for this respected house. So after creating process of ground story is completed, we need to copy the respected ground story to the remaining two stories. So before modeling of this respected building or any kind of the structure, we need to assume some important data which is related to the building design. So initially I will show you this respected data. So this is the data which is related to the G+2 building. So here we need to consider some of the parameters which are related to the building design. So first one is grade of concrete. So here I am considering it as M30 grade. Grade of steel, just I am considering it as 500 grade. Dimensions of the beam is 230 x 300. Column is 300 x 300. 125 is the slab thickness. Bottom story height is 3 meter. Height of the remaining story is 3 meter. So here I am considering live load will be consisting of 3 kN per meter square. Density of RCC is 25. Seismic zone condition is 5. Soil type is medium soil condition 2. Impotence factor is 1.5. Response reduction factor is 5. Damping ratio is 5%. Structure will be in C condition. Basic wind speed will be of 55 meter per second. Just I am considering risk coefficient will be of 1.08. Terrain coefficient of 1.14. Topography factor is 1.36. So wind design code is IS875-1987 part 3. RCC design code is IS456-2000. Steel design code is IS800-2007. Earthquake design code is IS1893-2002 code. So these are the basic data we need to follow before designing any kind of the structure. So I will attach this respected word file in the description. So you can download that respected file from the description also. Close this respected option. So initially go to Start Pro software. Click on Start Pro software here. Click on a new project, click on spacing option. So here we need to give the file name. Just I am taking it as G+2Z5. So here we need to select the location. Just I am selecting the location as the desktop, G+2Z5. Click on OK. So here we need to select the length units will be in meter as well as force units will be in kilonewton. Click on next button, click on finish button. The software will be open like this. So initially we need to keep the structure in front of you. So firstly we need to model the ground story for this respected G+2 building. So further go to geometry option, click on run structure wizard option. So here we need to select the model type. Just I am selecting it as frame models. Select the bay frame option. So initially we need to assume the length of the building. So as per my assumption, just I am taking it as 13 meter. So after that we need to assume the height of the building. Just I am considering ground story. So here I am taking it as 3. So after that we need to enter the width. Just I am considering it as 7. So after that we need to enter the number of bays along length direction. Just I am taking it as 3 and this is the 1, this is the 2. So after that select this respected 3 dots option. Now here we need to change the values of the length. So here I am considering first bay length will be consisting of 5. Again I am selecting second bay length will be of 5. Third bay length will be of 3. Click on OK. So after that select this respected 2 dots. So here I am considering first bay length will be of 4. Again second bay length will be of 3. Click on OK. Click on apply button. So this is my frame model. We need to import this respected model from structure wizard option to Snap Pro software. So for that, initially click on cancel button, click on edge button, click on OK. So now the model is imported to the StandPlus software here. So after modeling this respective ground story, we need to model the staircases here. So for that, keep your structure in top view again. Again, go to cut section command here. Click on selective view, click on OK. So here we need to cut this respected section. So again, keep the structure in isometric view. So here we need to copy these respective node points to the respected distance here. So here I am selecting the node cursor. Just I am selecting these two node points. Click on copy option. Click on paste nodes option in minus x direction, which is of minus 0.7. So click on OK. Again, I am taking the paste nodes option, which is of x direction minus 1.4. Click on OK. So after that, we need to select this respected internal beam. Click on insert a node point. Insert a node point at midpoint for creation of the landing slab. Click on OK. Again, we have to select this respected node cursor option. Again, we have to select this node. Click on copy. Click on paste nodes. X direction distance, which is of minus 0.7. Click on OK. Again, I am selecting paste nodes, which is of minus 1.4. Click on OK. So after that, we need to select this respected three nodes option. Select this three nodes option. Click on copy option. Click on paste nodes option. Again, we have to copy this respective nodes in Z direction, which is consisting of 0.8 meter. Click on OK. So it will create this respected option like this. So after that, we need to create the cantilever beam for this respected section. Select add beam command. Select the first point. Again, select your second point. Now we need to connect this respected node points with the help of the slab section. So select add four node plate, select first node point, select second node point, select third node point, select fourth node point. So in the same way, we need to add the staircases. So just I'm selecting first node point, select second node point, select third node point, again I'm selecting fourth node point. Again I'm selecting first point here, again I'm selecting second point, again I'm selecting third point, again I'm selecting fourth point here. So after that, we need to add this respected beam here also. So select add beam command, select first point, again select your second point. So click on hold structure command. So here we need to add the balcony for this respected section here. So for that, initially we need to select the node cursor. Just I am selecting this respected node point. Click on copy option. Click on paste nodes option, which is in x direction distance, which is of minus 1.4. Click on OK. So after that, we need to connect this respected four node points with the help of the slab section. Select add four node plate option, select the first point, select the second point, select third point, again click on fourth point. So after that, we need to connect this respected beam section with the help of the cantilever beam. Select add beam command, select first point here, again select your second point. In the same way, we need to connect this respected points here. Select first point, select second point. So after adding this respected balcony, we need to add the slab section for the rest of the building. So select add four node plate option, select first point here, again select second point here, select third point here, again select your fourth point. In the same way, we need to connect this respective slab section with the four node plate. So after adding the four node plate, we need to see this respected whole model in rendering view. Click on rendering view option. So this is my rendering view for this respected building. So this is my ground story. Now we need to create remaining two stories for this respected building. So for that, select all your building by using Ctrl A option. Go to transitional repeat in Y direction. Number of steps will be of 1. Each step will be consisting of 3 meter. And here we need to assume the steps are 2, not 1. Go to click on OK option. So it will create this respected option like this. So after that, select plate cursor. Select all the plates. Go to transitional repeat in Y direction. Number of steps will be of 2. Each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So after that, we need to see this respected model again in rendering view. Click on rendering view option. So this is my rendering view for this respected structure. So after modeling process completed, we need to define the beam sizes, column sizes and slab thickness for this respected structure. So for that, go to general option here. Click on define option. Select your rectangular section. So as per the problem statement, just I am assuming it has 230 x 300. For the beam section, 300 x 300 for the column section. So here we need to give the value as 0.23 x 0.3. Click on add button. So after that, we need to select the 0.3 x 0.3 for the column section. Click on close option. Again, we have to assign the slab thickness of 125 mm here. So click on thickness option. So here I am considering 125. Click on add button, close option. Now select 0.23 cross 0.3. Go to select option, beams parallel to x direction condition. Again go to select option, beams parallel to z direction condition. Click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after that select 0.3 by 0.3. Go to select option. So here we need to select beams parallel to y direction condition. Click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after that select the plate thickness. Click on assign to view option, assign yes. Now we need to see this respected model in rendering view again. Click on modeling option, click on rendering view option. So this is my rendering view for this respected house. It will be consisting of 0.23 cross 0.3 is the beam size, 0.3 cross 0.3 is the column size, and slab thickness will be consisting of 125 mm for this respected structure. So after that we need to assign the supports for this respected building. So click on general option, click on supports option, click on create option, add your fixed supports, select your front view option, select your support to. Now we need to select all the node points at the base. Click on assign to selected nodes, assign yes option. Now the fixed supports will be assigned for this respective structure like this. So after that we need to assign the load cases for this respective structure. So as per the problem statement, just I am taking the load cases will be consisting of dead load case, live load case, earthquake load case as well as wind load case. So initially we need to define the seismic loading condition. Select loads and definitions option, click on definitions here, select your seismic definition. Initially we need to click on add button. So here we need to select the IS code as per the definition. So here I am selecting as per IS 1893-2002. Click on generate option. So here we need to add the parameters which are related to the high seismic zone. So here I am selecting zone, which is of zone 5 condition with 0.36 is the factor. Response reduction will be of 5. Importance factor will be of important building with 1.5. Medium soil condition and RC movement resisting building. Click on generate option. So it will generate the parameters for this respective structure like this. So click on add button. So here we need to add the self-weight factor as 1. So after adding the self-weight factor, we need to calculate the beam dead load for assigning the seismic loading condition. So here I am calculating the beam dead load, which is consisting of 0.23 cross 0.3 is the dimensions. We need to multiply this respected value with the unit weight of the concrete, which is comes under 1.725 is the value. We need to assign the member weight, which is of uniform load. 1.725 is the value here. Click on add button, close option. So after that select uniform weight of 1.725, go to select beams parallel to x direction condition, select beams parallel to z direction condition, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after assigning the beam dead load, we need to define the wind loading definitions. Click on definitions option, click on add button. So here we need to add the type 1 wind 1, click on add button, close option. Now select type 1 wind 1, click on add button. So here we need to enter the intensity for the respected wind intensity for the respected height of the building. So I was already explaining you the video how to calculate the wind values by using IS 875 code as per the problem statement. So here I am entering the random values, which is of 0.5, which is acting at a height of 9 meter. Again I am selecting 0.3, which is acting at a distance of 6 meter. Again I am taking the value as 0.1, which is acting at a distance of 3. Click on add button. Now we need to add the exposure as 1, add, close. Select exposure 1 with the help of assign to view, assign yes option. So after that go to select your load case details option here, click on add button. Initially we need to define a seismic loading condition. So here I am selecting it as earthquake load in x direction condition, add it. Again I am selecting earthquake load in z direction condition, add it. Again I am selecting the load as wind load. Just I am taking wind load in x direction, add it. Again I am selecting wind load in z direction, add it. Again I am selecting dead load condition, select DL option, add it. Again I am selecting the live loading condition. So here we need to enter the load as LL, add it, close option. Select earthquake load in x direction condition, click on add button. So here we need to select the seismic loading condition with x direction factor 1, add button, close button. So after that select earthquake load in z direction, add it. Again I am selecting the load condition will be of seismic loading condition with z factor 1, add it, close option. Select wind load in x direction condition, add button. Select your wind load in x direction with factor 1, add option. Again I am selecting minus 1 is the factor, add it. Again, close option. Now select wind load in Z direction condition, add button. Now I am selecting wind load in Z direction condition with the windward facing of 1, add button. Again, I am selecting minus 1, add it, close option. Now select the dead load, add button. So here we need to add the self weight, add button, close option. Select the live load option, click on add button. So here we need to select the floor load. Now we need to enter the value of the pressure as per the problem statement. So here I am taking the intensity will be of 3, which is of minus value, minus 3, which is acting at a distance of 3 and 9 meter. Click on add button, close option. Select the self weight by using assign to view, assign yes option. So after that we need to add the load combinations. Select your load case details, add it. So here we need to select the auto load combinations. Just I am selecting it as Indian standard code. Click on generate option. So it will generate the load combinations like this. Click on add button, close option. So after that go to analysis and print option, add your now print, close option. Go to analyze option, run analysis, save it. So here we need to check for the zero errors for this respective structure. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. It was observed with zero errors 11.1x. Go to post processing mode, click on done option, apply your load cases, apply OK. So this is the deflection of this respected building due to presence of the dead loading condition. So after that select it as earthquake load X direction, Z direction, wind load X, wind load Z, dead load, live load. Now here we need to see the shear force diagram, bending moment diagram, which is related to this respected building. So for that select Fy value, deselect this bending moment diagram. So this is the shear force diagram for this respected structure due to presence of the live loading condition, earthquake load X direction, earthquake load Z direction, wind load X, wind load Z, dead load condition, live load condition. So after that select this respected MZ value, select load case as dead loading condition. So this is the bending moment diagram which is related to this respected bending moment diagram of G+2 building. So after that select plate load, apply your stress type as absolute pressure, apply OK. So this is the max absolute pressure for this respected structure due to presence of the dead loading condition, live loading condition. So here I am selecting this respected load as earthquake load. So earthquake load in Z direction, wind load X, wind load Z. So after analysis part is completed, we need to design this respected building as per IS 456 code. So for that go to select modeling, click on design option, select concrete design. So initially we need to select IS 456 code, click on select your parameters. Initially we need to deselect all selected parameters. From these parameters we need to pick compression, yield strength, yield strength of shear reinforcement, click on OK. So after that click on define parameters. So here we need to give the compressive strength as per the problem statement. So as per the problem statement we are assumed that grade of concrete is M30 and grade of steel is 500. So here we need to import this respected value 30,000. Click on add button. Again I am selecting yield strength which is consisting of 500,000. Click on add button. Select your section. So here also I am adding 500,000. Click on add button. Close option. So after that select commands option, select design beam command, click on add button, design column command, click on add button, design slab element command, click on add button, take off command, click on add button, close option. So after that select this respected question marks here, select FC by using assign to view, assign yes option. Select FY main by using assign to view, assign yes option. So after that we need to select one more question mark. So assign to view, assign yes option. Again I'm selecting section, assign to view, assign yes option. Select design beam, go to select option, beams parallel to x direction. Again go to select option, beams parallel to z direction. Click on assign selected beams, assign yes. Select design column, go to select, beams parallel to y direction. Click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. Select design element by using assign to view option, assign yes option. So after that go to analysis and print option, again click on add button, close option, go to analyze option, run analysis, save it. Again we have to check for the zero errors for the respected design also. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So here my model is observing the zero errors. Go to post processing mode, click on done button, select the beam option, select any one of the beam. Just I am selecting this respected beam number 60, just double click on it. Click on concrete design. So this is the concrete design which is related to this respected 60 beam which is consisting of 5 bars of 10 mm dia, 200 center to center distance top reinforcement, and bottom reinforcement will be consisting of 3 bars of 10 mm dia, 30 center to center distance, and stirrups will be consisting of 22 numbers, and which is of 8 mm bars. Center to center distance is 110 mm. Click on closer option. Select any one of the column for this respected structure. So here I am selecting this respected corner column, which is of 82. Double click on it. Click on concrete design. So this is the concrete design which is related to this respected column, which is consisting of 0.3 × 0.3 is the column size, which is consisting of 4 bars of 16 mm dia. AST percentage is 0.89 and AST requirement is 773 mm square. Click on close option. So after designing this respected building, we need to see the start output file. Click on start output file. So click on results option. Select concrete design. So this is the concrete design for this respected beam, column and each and individual calculations from the respected output file as per IS 456 code. So after that, click on close option. So after designing the beam, column, we need to design the foundation for this respected building. So further click on foundation design. So here we need to include this respected earthquake load, wind load, dead load, live load. Click on include option. Click on run start foundation. The fixed supports of this respected foundation will be directly imported to foundation software. So these are the fixed supports. We need to design the foundation for this respected fixed supports. So initially we need to create the load combinations. So for that, select loads and factors. Click on generate loads. So here we need to select it as Indian standard system. Click on generate and load combinations. For the service load combination, click on generate and load combinations. For the ultimate load combinations, click on OK. Click on cancel. Now select job setup. Click on create job. Give the job name. Just I am taking it as G+2, which is of isolated footing, and units will be in Indian standard system. So here I am selecting Indian SI. Assign to all supports, include all load cases. Click on create job. So click on cancel this. So click on isolated footing job. Click on designs and parameters, concrete and rebar value, this cover and soil type, footing geometry, sliding and overturning. Click on design option. Click on S button. So it will design the foundation as per IS 456-2000 code. So this is the design of isolated footing job. So here I am selecting foundation number 11. So it will be consisting of each and individual calculations and reinforcement values as per IS 456 calculation. So after that, select this respective starting page. So this is starting page, geometry, details and drawing. It will be consisting of all drawing details like this. So select GA drawing, select calculation sheet. So this is the process analysis and designing of G+2 building in high seismic zone like zone 5 condition by using StatPro VI test software. Thank you.